Hello. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Welcome to another community awareness series. This is the Drum Circle with Mr. Ubaka Hill. Last time we did it, we had a great time. There was a number of drummers that came out, and it's always fun. And Ubaka is a master percussion player, and she's going to guide us through this journey. So let's welcome Ubaka Hill.
Everyone for coming out. So happy to see you all coming out this afternoon. And I'm glad to see that everybody has a drum or something to play. Does anybody need something to play? Everyone has something to play. Okay. All right. Wonderful. Wonderful to see so many children here as well. So just a couple of things before we get started. One is, if you're wearing rings or hard jewelry, you want to take those off, because it can damage the drum skin, okay? And if you are borrowing somebody else's instrument, do take very good care of it, okay? And when you're done, bring all the instruments to the center circle, okay? But we're not time to be done yet, right? Because we're just getting started. But I just wanted to give you a little information before we actually get started. So how many of you have been in a drum circle before? Let me see your hands. Okay. Actually, rather than hands, make some sound. If you've been to a drum circle before, make some sound. Now, if you used to drum a long time ago and you haven't been drumming for a long time, make some sound. So now, let me see. If you are still in school, no matter what level, no matter what grade, if you are still a student, make some sound. Let's see. If you live in Jersey City, make some sound. If you don't live in Jersey City, make some sound. Beautiful. If you could name at least one person that you have heard of or you listen to their music who plays the drum, make some sound. Are 100 years old, make some sound.
I'm just 28 short.
If you are 90 years old, make some sound. 90 something. Not yet. If you are 80 something, make some sound. Okay.
Finished 79 in January, so yes. I'm 80.
Okay. If you are 70-something, make some sound. All right. Yay. That's 70. Okay. If you are 60-something, make some sound.
Wow.
60-something to this crowd. Okay. If you are 50-something, make some sound. Make some sound. If you are 30 something, make some sound. Good. If you are 20 something, make some sound. Not yet, you're not there yet.
I was.
If you are between 19 and 15, make some sound.
No, not.
If you are between 14 and 10, make some sound. If you are younger than 10. Make some sound.
Happy.
Younger than 10.
Make some sound.
Maybe not now. All right. Well, now that we have a sense of who's here, we'll also now have a sense of how we play together. So, community drum circles is really what the two words say. Community and drum circle. We sit in a circle, we have our drums, and we represent a community. And we are doing something that people have done all over the world for as long as we've been on the planet. Came together to play music, to celebrate, to have fun. So tonight is about coming together in a circle as a community to have fun. Now while you have fun, you're also going to learn something. I'm going to teach you a few things about drumming, okay? And just so you know, this drum is also available. So when someone wants to drum big, open this one in the middle, and whoever wants to play it will come to the middle, but not just yet. Okay, not yet. So anyway, so you've got to make a little bit of sound, and I'm gonna make a little bit of sound from my drum.
Good.
Me first. Nice. Shaker's getting there. Now, we even come up with a sound for the shaker, right? For the shaker, right, you get to shake it, but you also can make rhythm out of the shake, right? So just what you were doing was perfect, right? And even with that pattern, you can say, da, 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 ba, ba, dee, dee, da, da. Same thing, right? Or da, da, do, do, da. Yeah, see? Knee first, here we go. Like it, very nice. Now you gotta be able to tell, was that a face, was that a tone, okay? Face, tone, yes. You forgot. Okay, are you playing? You playing the drum, not leaning on it? You're playing it too, right? Good, okay, here we go. Here we go.
Good. Save.
going to count four, and you're going to come all the way back in. You ready? Here we go. One, two, three, four. Now I'm going to bring instruments in one at a time. Okay, shakers, get ready. Ready? On four. Two, three, four.
Go, go, go,
go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, go, All right, we have a lot going on. The music got a little wobbly. Do you have a piece that you want to perform?
I traded for.
Okay, you traded them around. Here we go. Yes, we can play this one.
The drums will get switched around.
So here's the thing. It's clear that we have a lot of different levels of skill and ability, right? Some of you are very, very, very beginner drummers. Some of you have been drumming a little bit. So now that I get to see who the master drummers are and who the master beginners are, I have a better sense of what rhythm to play. Okay? So those of you who played a little longer, you'll have a rhythm pattern that might be a little challenging or might add more to it. Those of you who haven't played that long, then you might have to just do a pattern that has one or two notes in it, okay? So that nobody gets frustrated and we get to just have a good time playing music. What happened? The music too loud for her? Is that him or her? Her? This girl? Too loud for her, so she was like, no, don't make me. No, I'm glad you all enjoyed yourself. All right. Okay. Okay. Let's try that again. We're gonna simplify. Now, those of you who have more experience in your hands drumming, I know who you are. You'll play the pattern, right? And the pattern is bass, tom, 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 bass, bass, tom, tom. All the experienced drummers right now. Thank you. drums. Okay, so listen. Those of you who are borrowing drums, we like to make sure everybody gets a chance to experience the drums. So, for this next song, let's shift the drums around.
There's a lot of these drums that we have here, which is great. One thing about drum circles is that you get to see the different drums and percussion instruments that are out.
You know, what might be popular now. You know, some drums are very popular now that weren't popular 30, 40 years ago in this very center, basement of this library. I was a part of that. The drum I started out on, actually is in that black and white photo you pointed to me. And I started out on a conga drum. And right now there are no conga drums in this circle. And that drum comes from the Latin culture, right? Cuba, Puerto Rico, Dominican Republic, Brazil, South American, Latin American countries. These drums, which are very popular now, but weren't popular that many years ago, especially in the United States, certainly popular in West Africa, that's where they come from, are these drums, which is called a djembe drum. Right? Any of the children know how to spell djembe? D, starts with a D. Even though it says djembe, it starts with a D. It's D-J-E-M-B-E. D-J-E-M-B-E. We just don't say the D. Djembe. And these drums are from West Africa. They came here with the West African drum and dance companies that came to America in the 60s, 70s, in downtown Manhattan. And how many of you have heard of Baba Olatunji? Baba Olatunji, blessings to him. He's now one of our ancestors. And he was one of the drummers, singers, who helped to make West African drumming very popular or common and just, you know, in the neighborhood. In the neighborhood, West African drumming. So that's what we're playing here. We're playing instruments mostly from West Africa, some from Latin America, like this drum. This is actually a drum. Some of you might be just sitting on a box, right, a cardboard box. But it's actually called a cajon. Cajon. And that also originates from Cuba as an instrument. Peru, Brazil, right, a lot of Latin American countries. Wanted to play a little bit so they can hear what that sounds like? That's all wood. We're playing drums that are wood and skin, animal skin. Yeah. You know what's interesting about this instrument? Is that it originally started out as a wooden crate, a wooden box, in the slave quarters of countries where slavery was normal. And so because drums were outlawed, people could not play drums. Africans, enslaved Africans, weren't allowed, were prohibited from playing the music of their culture and their ancestors. And so the furniture that was in the yard was basically wooden boxes. And so the enslaved Africans from West Africa, Ghana, Guinea, Mali, Senegal, Ivory Coast, were those primary West African countries that were Africans were enslaved and sent out throughout the world. And those who ended up in from Peru to Brazil, Cuba, that these people could not let the music die inside themselves. And so they sat on these wooden boxes and did exactly what he's doing here. Started tapping on them, started playing them, started remembering the music of the ancestors, of the Orishas, of the important ones, the old ones, the stories, the mythology, the medicine, the teachings, and it was played on wood. And then later, as a commercial instrument, it was named a cajon. It became a manufactured instrument. Black Percussion makes them. All the big percussion manufacturing companies now make this drum. And some people don't know the story. Don't know how it originates. And it's not that important that one doesn't know. It just makes it a little bit more interesting when you do know and when you start playing it.
A similar thing happened with the steel band in Trinidad. The old company did this carnival or a drum, and they come and they show me the song and they dance fantastic. People could play.
Amazing. So did you hear that? The steel pan drum? You know the steel pan drum, especially from Trinidad? You know, when it's carnival? And it was an oil drum. I'm just going to repeat so people hear what you said, that it was an oil drum. You know how the big metal drums that oil is delivered in? Again, the poor people, right, cut them, hammered them, made instruments out of them, and now people study them, go to Juilliard to learn how to play them. Carry on. Pay too much money to go learn to play an oil, a cut oil drum, or a wooden box. So anyway, it's just nice to have this kind of information, yes. This drum? Cajon.
What about this one
here? Bongos, the classic bongos. I know that would be pretty bongos. Classic. Now back in the day, now you say that. First of all, if you're younger than 50, you can't say back in the day. You can't be 15 and say back in the day. But that is hey, some of you are you know, older. Remember when all drums were called bongos? Every drum in sight was a bongo. Now we know better. There's only one bongo. Will the real bongo please stand up? That's the bongo. And now also countries. Okay, and then we have these type of drums, be careful. And then we have these type of drums, your type of drums, and these great drums, and your drum that you have right here with the colors on it, yep. And the drum that you have with the colors on it, these are not wood. These are not wooden drums. They are wood fiber, but they're not a tree drum like some of these other drums, and the heads are plastic. Okay, so it's different than playing trees, and goats.
Goats.
Trees and goat skin. That's a goat skin. Some drums have cow skin, calf skin, and then some drums plastic. Okay, that's enough. That is a class on a little bit of history of the drums and the type of drums that we have. Yes. Bongos also come out of Latin American music. Salsa, yeah, salsa, the dance bands. Okay? And then these frame drums, I have to say something about these. Wanna hold up your drums? Frame drums? Who else has a frame drum? Wanna hold up your drum for me? Your frame drum, that one. See this type of drum? Which is very different than the rest of these drums. This drum is called a frame drum. And this is the oldest type of drum. Old type. That you would find this kind of drum before you find the rest of these drums in archaeology.
When the women are the drums.
It was mostly played by women,
played with the hand. But you also find indigenous people for a long time, back in the day, anytime someone saw a drum like that, it was called what? A Native American drum. Remember that? Every flat drum is called a Native American drum. That's what you need to know. So, from indigenous people in this culture to women's ancient culture, this drum is very common. And guess who else this type of drum is common with? Shamans. Shamans and medicine people around the world. Don't necessarily play these barrel drums, these shaped drums. It's mostly the frame drums, the flat drums. So the shamans, the healers, the medicine people prefer this drum. And that's around the world, okay? From Alaska to, you know, Siberia, and the under, from South Pole, okay? All right, so there you have it. Everything you need to know about drumming. And yes, I hear the bell. Now that bell is called a what?
Cowbell.
Now, what's up with that first word, cow?
A go-go.
Yeah, why is it cow? What does a cow have to do with the bell? That's right. Originally, people who herded cows as well as sheep would put bells on their necks. And the bell had a certain note so that the owners of that herd would recognize their herd. And that's from sheep of Switzerland to cows all around. So it remains with the name cowbell. Okay? And then, like you said, we have a go-go bell, the double-head Brazilian bell. Yeah, what's the show? Well, thank you for that opportunity to share some information about this drum. So anyway, some drums are played sitting down or sitting on top of it. This type of drum, you can also play it standing, and that's what I'm about to do. What's that? Not this audience. Okay. So anyway, the way I'm putting this, I'm wearing this drum is like West Africans do. Okay. And some drums, again, people sit down and play. But in West Africa, you get to put it on with a belt and stand up and play it, move around with it, and so forth. Okay? All right. And got to watch for the long hair without being entangled in the rope. Okay. All right, very good. So let's carry on. You ready to carry on?
Yes.
Let's carry on with another song. Another drum song. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, so here's the thing. Now I have to, I'm gonna do some sign language of some sort. So, when I hold this up, when I hold this up, that means the only people that are playing are the ones playing the hand percussion. So if you're not playing a drum, then you're playing what? Hand percussion. You might be playing a stick or a bell or a shaker, right? But you're not playing a drum. So we're drumming along, and I go like this. Who plays? And who stops playing? The drums stop playing, because if the hand percussion is the only one playing, that means the drummers have to stop. Okay? And then when this hand goes down, this is going away, and then this is coming up, this means the drummers play. Right? So if you're playing hand percussion, what does that mean? If you're playing hand percussion, this goes up, what does this mean?
Drum!
The hand percussion stops. Okay? And then when I go like this, use the same rhythm patterns, if I think you like that. That one sounded pretty groovy to me. Right? So let's play the same rhythm pattern. I had already invited some of you who have a little bit more experience in your hands. You can change the pattern up, right? Improvise on a little bit. That's always fun. I will keep the main pattern. Okay? And we're going to then also jam. Now, you're playing a pattern. Right? That's the same pattern. We're going to go to the other one. Thank you. another round, and then we're going to take a break, because there are some refreshments back there, and I'd like you, you know, to have them. And welcome those of you who just came into the circle. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Ah, come on, welcome. Thank you.
Thank you.
for another rhythm pattern? Ready for another pattern?
Yeah.
Now this time, you're going to get to improvise. Basically meaning that you get to create your own, okay? All the other rhythm patterns, I showed you what to play, you played it. This time you're going to create your own. Now for those of you who are just learning how to drum, that's going to be more challenging for you. Because it's tricky.
Thank you.
do, we're not ending, we're just gonna, you know, get into the next circle here. Before we do, I just want to thank Dao David Williams again for bringing me out. CAS programs, and not only that, you know, history. You know, history is very, very important, right?
That's good.
It's just good to know. And what's good to know is that Daoud is one of the primary founders of the Community Awareness Series. And you know, I was a little snippet with it around that time, in the mix. And but also in that, I just want to appreciate that for what, 30, 38 years, that Daoud has been keeping this center alive in this community for 38 years. And you can only imagine that it is not, it was not, and will never be a small feat. That it took a lot of screaming, kicking, and demanding. Hold on, children, hold on. And demanding that in this community, in this urban community, that there be quality music, quality art, quality film. Play act, you know, not just messing around, but bringing in high-ranking musicians and artists from around the world right into this neighborhood. And so that's worth a lot of applause, and it's important. Children, that you're here. Children, you see me? Go, children. I'm in. Children, this is going to be yours. It's very important, children. You're looking at me? You listening? That someday, you're going to be the one who are bringing the musicians and the artists into the center and making sure that quality art comes into this Jersey City community, okay?
Yeah.
All right? Can we make a promise about that? You said no. You said no, put that on me. But anyway, Dolly, thank you so much again. And all the people who are part of the community to make this happen. Also, I have to say that knowing the backstory, the history of how we've come to where we are, it also includes documenting the story. So I believe all the programs here in those 38 years have been either photographed or filmed, am I right? So there is a photographic and a film archive. So you'll see me as a 17-year-old and then as a 59-year-old.
Thank you.
You should all yourself, all the jewelry. You should always listen to the person drumming next to you, because we're drumming with others, not just drumming ourselves. And when somebody's leading the drum circle, that's the person you listen to the most and watch the most, because you might miss something, especially when there's an opportunity to do something interesting. Okay? The other thing is, if you're borrowing a drum from someone, it's not your drum. This is what the great teacher Baba Olatunji taught me, taught us. That when someone loans you their drum, take good care of it, because they are giving you their heart. That's what Baba said. And so whether it's a drum you borrow, or whether it's your own drum, to take good care of it. Because the drum is the heartbeat of humanity. And we all have a heart. And we're all tied together in unity, community through the heartbeat. And the drum is the heartbeat expressed outside of our bodies. So we're going to close the circle with a heartbeat song, okay? And this heartbeat song comes from... A lot of negotiations. This song comes from the Nyabingi people. The Nyabingi people of Jamaica. And the Nyabingi is a music form that predates reggae. So before reggae, there was Nyabingi. And the Nyabingi music is the music of the earth-loving people. The people who respect the earth, who live off the earth, who don't participate in capitalism, but really relies upon the food, the water that earth provides and takes care of it. And so they are the first Rastafari.
Right.
The Rastafari comes from the Nyabingi. So before they call themselves Rastafari, they call themselves Nyabingi. And then from there, Rastafari, from there, reggae, ska, and on from the music coming out of that part of the Caribbean. Yes?
What's the name of the rhythm?
Nyabingi.
That is the rhythm name? I'll give,
it's called Nyabingi. It's very slow moving. It's all centered around the heartbeat. And here's how you spell it. N-A-N-Y-A, Nyabingi. 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 If you're comfortable doing research, Google it. It's interesting. And it's history. Because it was the Nyabingi that fought off the Spanish colonizers that came into Jamaica. It was the Nyabingi who fought for the right of the indigenous people to remain sovereign on that land. It didn't quite work out, however. The French people, they're still there in the role as stewards of the land. Okay? Nyabingi.
Nyabingi.
Nyabingi. You can say it. That was good. Nyabingi. Yes, good one. Big long word. Okay. So we're going to start with the heartbeat, everyone. Okay? Everybody? Focus in. It's all about the heartbeat. Okay? Here we go. You ready? Here we go. We're starting right here. Rest. Rest. Yeah. that we are connected to the heart. Let's just remember that one thing, that we are connected to the heart in all beings, as a pulse, all beings, small or large, as rhythm, the heart of life. The first thing we listen for, the expected baby. Let's remember that we're connected, that we're connected, that we're connected at the heart. Beautiful.